Hello guys, welcome to another video from Blue King's FX Academy. In this video, I'm going to be explaining how to understand when a trend is changing, okay? Either from an uptrend to a downtrend, from a downtrend to an uptrend, okay? So I'm going to make this video as brief as possible. So first of all, what is an uptrend? Okay, an uptrend is actually a market algorithm that consists of higher highs and higher lows. Okay, higher highs and higher lows. Now, if you look at how I drew these schematics here, we're going to find out that this high is lower than this high. So this high is higher than this. This one is higher than this. This one is higher than this. This one is higher than this. This is how an uptrend ought to look like. Now, it doesn't look as perfect as how I drew it here, but on the charts, whenever you look at the charts, you should be able to see higher highs and higher lows before you can call what you're seeing an uptrend. Then, what is a downtrend? A downtrend is a trend that consists of lower highs and lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, right? Lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, right? Just continue like that. Now, if it doesn't keep getting lower, like if you don't keep seeing lower highs and lower lows, then you know that okay, this is not a downtrend. Maybe it's a range or some kind of I don't know. But uptrends consist of higher highs and higher lows. Downtrend consists of lower highs and lower lows. Then we have range. Range consists of sideways movement, okay? Some highs are higher than the other, some are lower than the other, like that. Okay, it doesn't have any specific direction. Okay, I'll call that one the range. Okay, so in this video, I'm going to explain how to know when a trend is changing, because many people get this part wrong, because it's important to know when a trend is changing. So now let's look at an uptrend. Now, no matter how funny this trend looks like, even if it does this, now look at what I just drew here. Even if it does this, it's still an uptrend. Why? Because this high is higher than this high, right? And this high is higher than this high. This high is higher than this high. So you still consider this an uptrend, because even if this high is higher than this high with just a week, I'm going to consider it an uptrend, because on a lower time frame, that week is actually two candles, okay? One going up and one coming down. So now let's check out something different. So when you see something like this happen on its own, then note we don't have an uptrend valid here again. All right, okay, this is not perfect. Let me draw something better. Have something like this continuously going up, and then all of a sudden you see this, right? See that this is not an uptrend anymore, but some people will still want to buy here. If you buy here, you face a higher risk of losing money. Why? Because this is no more an uptrend again. It's changing rapidly, okay? It's changing rapidly. The US 30 is falling. It's changing rap. Wow, speed. It's changing rapidly, okay? So that's how we know when an uptrend is changing to a downtrend, right? You see the algorithm that you ought to look at. You have to see higher highs, but in this case, this high is higher high. Why shouldn't there be a higher high here? Then fine, you're like, okay, something is wrong. If there is no higher high here, this high is not equal to this. Something is very, very wrong. So this has changed from an uptrend to a downtrend. So what you should start looking for, entries on how to get in for sales and no more for buys, right? So in this case scenario, when do you get in for your sales? You get in for your sales when you have seen an opportunity to get in, an opportunity like this, okay? An opportunity like this, you get in for yourself. Some traders that are aggressive can get in right here, okay? So that is when you know that, okay, this trend has changed, because the trend can change anytime. That's the market for you. It can change, it can even change when you just pick an order, a buy order. Not here, change your downtrend on your order. That's why there is no strategy that is perfect. There is no trading system that is perfect, because this trend changes every time. Okay, so now let's look at okay, so let's look into something now for the downtrend part of it. So let's look at the downtrend part of it, how to spot when a downtrend is changing. Take note, it's just an inverse, okay? It's just an inverse, nothing more. Okay. When a downtrend is changing to an uptrend, it's just an inverse. So let's say you see this lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows. Okay. You keep seeing that. Now, when stuff like this happens, don't ever look to keep selling this. Why? Because you're getting two equal lows, right? So two equal lows mean that this algorithm has changed, okay? This algorithm as well has changed from being lower high, lower low stuff to equal lows. Equal lows means bulls have entered into this market. So you shouldn't look for buys anymore. You should look for sales. Sorry, you shouldn't look for sales anymore. You should look for buys. So some aggressive traders will actually get in at this point, while some will get in after little move to the upside, okay? Wait for a break of structure, pull back, and keep. So when a trend wants to change, it starts with this, okay? And most times this thing happens in a way that it looks so deceptive, in a way that this will be weak right here, understand? Making But you'll be like, okay, we still have lower highs here, lower highs here. So you feel, okay, we are seeing a downtrend. It's a lie, it's just deception, okay? This thing you see right here, that shows that, okay, price has started changing from an uptrend to a downtrend. Sorry, from a downtrend to an uptrend. So no matter, even if you see price play, even if you see price play this way and start coming towards the side like this, as long as that candle coming there has not finished forming, do not still sell, okay? Because this could be liquidity coming to grab here and take up, right? So do not sell as long as you have seen this, until you see the candle that came back here formed continuously, come back, create a what, a lower high again before you can go back. Okay, the trend has gone back to a downtrend, you can start looking for sales again. But as long as it has not created a lower high and a lower, as it just created this lower low now, it came back up and did something like this. I want to say, no, don't try it. Okay, I've lost a lot of money from setups like this, trying to sell when seeing that that's happened this way. So, right in this video, I'm just here to share my ideas. Okay, I'm not every anything in this video, make sure you test it on your demo. Practice, observe, okay, before you take it live, please. Okay, nobody's perfect in the market. I'm just here to share my ideas, things I've observed, right? My weeks of study and the rest. Okay. So I want to show you guys something live. Okay. So something live is here. All right. So you know what I want to show you guys. This is US Tech. Okay. I love US Tech so much. Recently, say you're liking it. Now if you watch. In this range, I took these buys, okay, but just forget about that buy. I'm going to explain that in the different concepts that made me take that buy, right? So if you watch this, this is a complete downtrend. See lower lows and lower highs, lower lows, lower highs. What do you ever see me do? I've been looking for sales. One, the first sell, second sell, third sell, fourth sell. Okay, so just looking for sales. Now, at this point, what did you see? Did you see me take any cell here? No. Why didn't I take a cell here? Now, this is because trend is clearly changing. You can't see this and still look for cells. Wait, was so many people here or here or wherever looking for cells? Maybe trying to check if this thing was an order block and all that, and I was looking for cells. No, this is not what a lower low. Again, this week is higher than this week. So bulls have stepped in here. So this can, you can't find what a sell setup here. So rather you look for a buy setup. Some people who want to take a buy setup, I think Qbanks caught something like this, going up to the upside. He took these buys. Understand? So at this part, you don't have to look for sell opportunities because it's making lose money. Okay, so when next should you look for a sell opportunity? When another low has swept these lows. Now, if you check, this low swept this low. This particular low, watch it. This week here is lower than this week. So on the, as it's still coming back to retest, then you see me taking this sell in between. If you watch, I took a trade right there, US 30. Okay. See this cell, I took it right here because I know that this low has gone lower than this. So as it was coming back to retest, I saw an order block that had to be mitigated right here. It just touched on the smaller time frame and then it moved straight 457 pips US 30. Now, exactly what I'm teaching you guys in this video, I made the same mistake of seeing what happened here. Lower, these lows are not lower than this. So I shouldn't look for any sell again. But what happened? I looked for a sell and you see that it just went against me with speed. Why? Because this new low form is not lower than this low, it's higher and it's even equal with this. So trend has changed again. Because why? These trends are constantly changing. So don't look at, because I'm in a downtrend, it's keep going down forever. No, it can change anytime. So be careful to look whether a trend is changing before you get in. All right. So now, at this point, why am I taking the sales? Okay, these shorts here. Let me show you why I'm taking the sales. Let's go to the daily time frame. The daily time frame setup. All right. Looking at this, we are seeing a clear downtrend overall. And this low form is lower than this low. And there's an order block here that has to be mitigated after the pullback. So I consider this a full pullback based on daily time frame perspective. So this order block here was refined to something like this, okay, and was still further refined to something smaller, I think. Yeah, something smaller. So I took two entries. First entry, I was rushing. Those of you that are managing your accounts, go and find out that I entered too early right here, fear of missing out, because I saw a long week when US 30 was trying to. I thought, okay, this was the rejection we're looking for, so I got in and kept pushing up. So I just set my stop loss above. I knew that, okay, if I'm still right about this setup, then okay, I'm still right about the setup, then US 30 will just get here and fall. If I'm right about the setup, but if it crosses this place, I know I'm wrong about the setup, and then I take the loss. Okay, so I took another entry at this other block, exactly at the other block. You can see that it's in heavy profits right now. Heavy profits right now. Let me check how many pips. So 150, 132 pips in profit. All right. So now I'm still holding because US 30 ought to fall, I think, somewhere around here. Then I'm able to close. Now there's something you should find out. Every time frame has its perspective of trend. Okay. So on a 4-hour time frame, if you're seeing an uptrend on the daily time frame, you are seeing an uptrend. On 15-minute time frame, you are seeing a downtrend. What should you obey? The higher time frame analysis should be paramount. Okay. On the 4-hour time frame, my dear, this is not a pure uptrend. Downtrend is not. It can cast sentences like, you should be like, why are you still selling? All right. But something higher than it is saying that we are seeing a downtrend and went lower than previous low, and we are about mitigating a very strong order block. An order block in the daily time frame is sure stronger than an order block in the 4-hour time frame. That's what you should know. Okay, so that's what you should actually keep in mind. right, when you're trading other blocks and understanding the trend. So this shouldn't confuse you. Lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows. That makes it a downtrend. Lower highs, lower lows, lower highs, lower lows, lower lows, like that, right? Should make it a downtrend. Then an uptrend, should be higher highs, higher lows. Anything that makes this thing go out from this algorithm, the trend is changing. So you should be very smart, all right, to pick where the trend is changing, all right? Thank you for watching this video. Do well to click on the like button and subscribe to this channel, turn on notifications so that more videos from here you're going to notice via your phone's notification and get to watch it, all right? Thank you for supporting the channel. Goodbye.